Hi guys, how do you do traditional programming wizards? Guys, for today we'll continue the Android JSON series of tutorials. Today we're going to see how to work with multiple activities. Right here, of course, this is a JSON data. We've looked at it previously. We said the whole of this one right here is a JSON array. This is what shall be downloading. We shall be putting our browser to this particular URL. Our JSON array, of course, consists of JSON objects, which of course are separated by this right here, comma. So it's single JSON object, of course, here. Simply represent a single user with all these properties. For us, we shall be interested in the name, the username, and the email. These are the data that we're going to be dealing with. So for us, let's proceed down right here. We're having a simple demo application here. Of course, we click our fab button right here. It's going to download our data very fast right here, and you can see it passes that particular data and show it right here in our custom grid view. Okay, so if we click a single item, then it's going to open for us the detail activity. Now this is a detail activity right here. Okay, you can see we are passing in the name, we're passing in the username, we're passing in the email. The others right here are static. Now for us guys, this is what you're going to see. This is dynamic. If I come click this other one, you can see right here the name, email, and of course username that we're working with, of course, are being passed dynamically. Okay, so this is it. We are going to see how to work with the JSON data and of course multiple activities. This is what we are going to develop in these particular tutorials. So guys, join me, we get started. What we want to do, of course, is to create our project. So go ahead, create our project in Android Studio. Once we've done that one, then let's come over right here to our build.gradle. The first thing we're going to need, remember, are going to be working right here with a custom grid view. Our grid view is going to consist of card views. So make sure that you add this particular right here, library, support library, of course, for card view. Okay, we shall also be working, of course, with our floating action button. So we're going to need our design support library. So please add those two and then come right here, sync our project. Once we've done that one, let's go ahead, move over to our layout inside our manifest. So for us, of course, we shall be downloading our JSON data from online. So make sure that you have this particular permission for connect to the internet. Then of course, we shall be working right here with the static image. I'm just added right here an image. Then for our layouts, and of course, Android Studio is going to generate for us these two activity, the main and then the content main. That is if we chose the basic activity as our template. Inside our content main, I require you guys to add your grid view. Okay, so make sure that you add over your grid view inside the content main dot XML layout. Add, come right here, add grid view, given my two columns. Then of course we're going to add a custom grid view, a custom layout right here that I've called model. This is the layout that of course we're going to inflate to represent a single view item inside our grid view. Okay, so this is our model dot XML right here. So for me, this one right here is my layout model.xml. okay, so it's simple for me. I'm just having three text views that I'm placing them right here in a linear layout. Okay, so you can just go ahead and then of course design yours. Here right here is my layout. Actually, all this particular source code, we're going to have them in our website, so don't worry about them. Okay, so this is my model.xml. It's just three text views. I've placed them inside my linear layout whose orientation right here is vertical. Then of course activity detail, this is going to be the layout right here. This particular of course XML, this is going to get generated for us when we create a new activity, a detail activity. For me, what I've done is simple. I've simply added a simple card view inside it. Then inside my card view, of course, I've added right here a couple of text views and then one static image right here. Okay, so this is it, guys. This is the card view. This is the detail view that you are seeing over there. So that's it. Of course, this one also, we're going to have all the source code in our website. Everything right here we shall be having in our website, so you shall have it over there as your reference, guys. These are our layouts. Let's move over to our classes. To have a couple of classes over right here, we're going to organize these particular classes in packages. The first package, mjson, this is going to contain classes that shall be of course relating to our networking. of course, we shall be downloading a data, and then of course passing that particular data. So we are going to have the connector class. This is a class that's going to help us establish our HTTP URL connection to our network. We shall be making a GET request to our server. Then of course, JSON downloader right here. This is where we shall be downloading our data. Okay, it's inside our background thread. Then of course, JSON parser will also be passing our data using in a background thread. Okay, we're just simply going to be using the org.json classes. We're not using any third-party library to pass. User, this is our model class, is going to represent a single data object that we're dealing with. Custom adapter, this is the class where we shall be, of course, adapting our data to our views, our custom views. Then, of course, detail activity, which we shall open. Main activity right here, our launch activity. So let's come over right here, get started with the simplest one, which is our user class. This is a simple class, is representing a single user. Our user is going to have a username, name, as well as the email. Then of course right here we're going to have their getters and setters. Well, this is it. This is our user class. Next, let's move over to our connector class. This one is just a very simple class. Right here we're going to have one simple method, a static method. Okay, I'm going to call it connect. The method is going to return for an object. First, it's going to take a JSON URL, which is a string. Now, inside that try catch block, the first thing we're going to do is instantiate our java.net.url, passing in our JSON URL, which is a string. Okay, as we do that one, we shall be coming right here and catching a malformed URL exception if we specified the wrong format for our URL. Okay, then of course, once we've done that one, we're going to come right here. URL.open connection. This one right is going to give us a URL connection object, which of course is the superclass of our HTTP URL connection. So we cast it. Remember, we are making a HTTP GET request. So then let's come over right here. Yes, our request method, we are making a GET request to our server. We come set other properties like connect timeout and read timeout, which is going to be 15k milliseconds. We set our do input to true, because our connection rate is going to support input of data. We shall be downloading data into application. Then right here we return that particular con object. As we do that one, we shall also be catching IO exception, and take note, if we are having an error, we're going to start with the term error right here. So this is it guys, this is our connector class. Let's move over to our downloader class. So downloader class, this is a class of course shall be connecting to our work using our connector class. Remember, then we download data in the background thread. That means that we're going to subclass our async task. Then of course we pass that, we send that particular data to our parser class for it to be passed. Okay, so the first thing of course we've said right here, this class right here, we're going to be passing in a context, a JSON URL, as well as a grid view. Then you're also going to be showing a progress dialog. The first thing that we're going to do over right here, we're going to come go ahead over right here. Well, we're going to make this class right here, of course, derived from async task. We're going to make it subclass async task. With this one, we'll have to implement a couple of methods. So we come first, we're going to have our own pre-execute. This is the method that shall be called just before our task in the background starts. We'll take that initiative, of course, to go ahead and then initialize our progress dialog, which shall be showing while downloading our data. So first we come set the title, set the message, then show it. Doing background, this one shall be performing our background task, okay, in the background thread, of course. Then of course the result of this particular doing background method is going to be passed to our own post execute. Inside our own post execute, for us, we're going to first of course dismiss our progress dialog, then of course call our parser class. Now take note right here, whatever is getting passed right here, our result of doing background method is basically our JSON data that shall be downloading. So that simply means that what we're going to be doing right here is simple. We shall be downloading our data. So let's come over right here and define how we shall do that one. To download our data, we're going to have this simple method right here that we're going to have right here. Private no is going to return for us a string. We're going to call the method download. So our download method over here, the first thing to download our data, we're going to come right here, have an object that we're going to call connection. So for this one, we're going to get this particular connection from our connect method of our connector class, as long as we pass in our JSON URL. But then before we do that one, let's just move ahead over right here and then create our constructor. So for the constructor, we said we shall be passing in the context JSON URL and then our grid view from our main activity. So we do that one. Then of course we come over here, we have our connection object. The first thing we're going to do, we're going to cast this connection object to string. Okay, then we check if it starts with the term error. So if this is the case, we're simply checking if it's an error that we're being returned. If this is the case, then that's what we're going to pass over to our on post execute. So we come right here, connection dot to string. So of course we're going to exit over there and then pass that particular error. Now if you're having an error with your connection, we're simply going to display that error, okay, inside in a simple toast message. We're not going to try to download. Otherwise, if we don't have an error, then we're going to proceed on and then download our data. Now to download our data, this is what we're going to do. First, of course, we need an HTTP URL connection. So we simply cast our object right here, our connection to HTTP URL connection. Then of course, once we've done that one, we're going to come over here and then get our response code. So response code, of course, we get from our HTTP URL connection by calling get response code method. We check if it's HTTP okay, then of course we move on, we proceed and then download our data. Otherwise, if that's not the case, then okay, we're going to show that particular response message. That's what we're going to return. Okay, but of course if it's HTTP okay, then we proceed on to download our data, of which first we instantiate our buffered input stream, passing in our input stream which we get from our HTTP URL connection object. We're also going to have our buffered reader right here. Buffered reader, we instantiate it, passing in an instance of input stream reader, post which we pass in input stream right here in our reader. So we're going to be reading our data line by line, storing them inside this line variable over here. All the particular lines, we're going to be appending them to adjacent data here, which is a string buffer. So we come to read our line. As we read line by line, we are assigning to this particular line variable and then at the same time checking if it's not equal to null. Then of course we go ahead, append those particular lines to adjacent data. At the end of the day, we want to make sure that we release our scarce resources over here. So we come, just close our buffered reader, we also close our input stream. Then of course we cast our JSON data to string, remember it was a string buffer. Then of course we return it. Okay, so yes, that's it. To execute it, of course we simply come right here, call the download method, then it shall be passed right, it's going to pass the result right here to our on post execute. What we're going to do first, we check if our JSON data, okay, that starts with the term error. If this is the case, then we know that we are having an error. So what we're going to do, we're simply going to display a simple toast message right here. The context, you're going to have our context. Then of course we're simply going to display that particular error. So JSON data, okay, in fact this one right here should be here, it's an error. So let's come just right here, say error equal to JSON data. Then of course we display it right here, error. Otherwise, if that's not the case, then of course we're going to proceed on and then of course call our parser class, which is going to pass our data. This does it. Let's move over to our JSON parser class. Thus, this is the class we shall be. We receive our downloaded data, pass it, and then of course call our adapter class for it to be bound to our custom grid view. So yes, first we're going to come, go ahead, make sure that we subclass our async task. Then of course once we've done that one, we're going to come right here, override a couple of methods. On pre-execute, the method that shall be called just before we start our background work. Okay, we're going to go ahead, show a progress dialog manual. Then during background, we shall perform our passing. On post-execute, called once we're through with our passing of our data. So we're also going to come over right here and then just in via the constructor, pass in our context JSON data as well as our grid view. Okay, then of course once we've done that one, we're going to implement how we're going to pass our data. So for us, we said we're going to be returning right here boolean, the method we're going to call pass. Well, the first thing we're going to do over right here is simple. Inside our try catch block, we come pass our JSON data, of course inside the JSON array as we instantiate it right here. So we're going to have written our JSON array containing all our JSON data. We just declare JSON object. Now users right here, this is a simple array list that is going to contain all our users. Take note, of course, our JSON data is simply a list of users with all their properties. Okay, we make sure first we clear that particular list, then we go ahead, just declare single user. Now we come loop through our JSON array. So we come right here. As we loop through, for each particular iteration, we shall be getting a JSON object. Remember, a JSON array simply consists of a JSON objects. So we get each single JSON object by passing in the index and then, of course, calling in our get JSON object. Of course, once you've done that one, we're going to extract the name by calling the get string and also username. Also, we simply have to pass in these particular names right here that we're passing right here. Please, they have to correspond to what you have in your JSON data. So you have to check your JSON data and see that you have a field known as name or a field known as username or of course email. Then of course to instantiate a single user, we come set the name, username and the email. Make sure that we add that particular user to our users collection. Return true if we've successfully passed our data. Otherwise, if you're having a JSON exception, then we are going to return false. That's it, guys. That's how we're gonna pass our data. To pass it, of course, we simply call our pass method. Then of course, once you've done that one, we're going to come right here. Let's check if we successfully passed. If passed, then what are you going to do? Well, we're going to call our binder, no, our adapter class, of course, to adapt our data. Otherwise, if that's not the case, then we are simply going to display a simple toast. Now for us, we're simply going to tell the user at runtime unable to pass. That's it. Okay, that is if you're having a JSON exception, guys. This is it. This is our parser class right here. It's going to help us, of course, pass our data. This one right here, we're having a grid view. So let's come right here, grid view in our custom grid view. That's it, guys. Let's move over to our custom adapter class. Class, this is where, of course, this class is going to subclass our base adapter. This is where we shall inflate our model.xml layout. It's also where we shall be binding our data to a custom grid view. So the first thing, we're going to make it derive from base adapter as usual. Then of course we come override a couple of methods right here. First, let's come pass in our context as well as our users over here. Okay, context, and then of course an array list of users. Get count right here, we're going to return the total number of users. So users.size, this is going to be the total number of users. Then of course get item, we want a single user, so users.get, then we pass in the index right here which represents the position of that particular user. Get item id, we're going to use that particular position as our id. Then of course right here, get view, this is where we shall be inflating our model.xml layout. Then of course we return it as a view object. To inflate it, first we're going to check if it's null. Okay, we only want to do it in case it's null. Okay, because inflation is an expensive process, we shall just check if our view object is null. Then of course is when we're going to inflate it. Otherwise it shall be recycling particular views. So layout inflator dot from, we pass in our context, then we call the inflate method. We pass in the layout that we want to inflate, in this case r.layout.model of course .xml. okay, so right here we're going to have r.layout.model. then of course what's our view group? Our view group is right here, view group. Then of course our attach root, we're going to come right here and say false. So once we've done that one, then we come here. Let's come, we come first here, we get the text views. Okay, name txt, email as well as the username. These are the text views that shall be shown in that particular grid. Then of course we get a single user by simply calling the get item. Take note, the get item, as long as we pass in the index, this is or the position, this is going to return for us an object. We cast it to a user, this is going to give us a user object. So yes, we have a user object. Now we can simply use that particular user object to get name. Okay, right here, user.get name, get email, and then get username. Then you assign them to these variables. We've made them final because we shall be calling them instead of on click listener in a short while. Now, first, before that one, of course, we're going to go ahead and then set them to our text views. Well, of course, once you've done that one, guys, let's come go ahead right here and then say, remember, we have our view object. We want that if this particular view object or our view item right here is clicked, okay, if a single grid is clicked, we want to open an activity. So we're going to come override our implement our on click listener. So if this particular view object is clicked, if on click method is called, we shall want to open a new activity for us. Okay, now to do that one is simple. What we're simply going to do, let's come create a simple method that's going to help us to open a new activity. Okay, open activity. So this method right here, of course, we made it private, then it's going to return a void. We're going to call it open a detail activity. Okay, so this method right here is going to take a string param. Well, of course, we're going to, so take note of the three dots. In fact, I'm going to call it details here as param that's going to contain our details, our user details. Now the first thing, we're going to need an intent. So let's come right here, intent android dot content dot intent. I equal to new intent, we instantiate it. Okay, so new intent over here. Then of course, what do we pass in? First we pass in the constructor, then of course we pass in our target activity, which is our detail activity dot class. So once we've done that one, of course we're going to go ahead and then attach our data. Of course right here, this is one, let's have it as details. Okay, so first we specify, we call the put extra method. Of course we specify the key. This is the key that shall be used to retrieve this particular data, for instance right here, name key. So that shall mean that our first item, we are going to be passing in the name, of course the email key right here. The second item, we shall be having the email. Thirdly, we're going to have our username. Okay, once we have that one, now we simply start our new activity by passing in, calling at the start activity, then passing in our intent. This does it. That's what we're going to do. To implement it, you are simply going to come right here, call open detail activity. What do we pass in? Well, first we said the first one is the name, then of course we pass in the email, then of course we pass in the username. Guys, that's it. This is how we're going to open a detail activity and pass our data. Okay, now inside our detail activity, so over to our detail activity right here. Of course, first we're going to have these three technology. This one right here, we inside our detail activity, name txt, email txt, username txt. These are the views that are going to hold our data. Okay, so first of course we come then reference them over here. Once you've done that one, then of course we're going to come right here and then get our intent. Okay, so get intent. Now to get our intent, we're simply going to say intent I equal to this dot get, sorry, this dot get intent. We simply get it as a property of this our activity. Once we have that one, guys, then we're going to proceed on receive our data. Now take note right here, when receiving our data, we call get extras, get string. Then inside a string method, we pass in the key. So the keys that you specified right here, they have to correspond to what you specified right inside our adapter class. Okay, where we were packing data to our intent. Now come right here, name key, email key, and then username key. Then of course, to bind our data, we simply call the set text method of our respective text views. This is our detail activity. Let's move over to our main activity. So inside our main activity, this is simple. First, we specify the URL shall be connecting to. This is our URL, of course. This particular URL right is going to give us our JSON data. Then of course we have our grid view. We come reference our grid view. Then we simply come here. Then of course, start our downloader by calling we instantiate our JSON downloader, passing in the context, our JSON URL, our grid view. Then we call the execute method. Guys, this is it. This is a JSON downloader class is going to, no, this is our main activity class. Okay, it's how we're going to start our downloading when our fab button is clicked. Otherwise, just make sure that you've added your permission right here for connection to the internet. And that's it. Let's run our project and see what we have. Just before project, we've really forgotten something quite basic. Let's move over to a JSON parser class. We need to call set our grid view, of course, to our adapter. Okay, so come right here to bind. Of course, we're going to come right here. Now we're going to say jv.setAdapter. Okay, adapter, which is right here. We call our set adapter method. Then, of course, we're going to pass in our custom adapter. Okay, it's instance, so custom adapter. Then we pass in, of course, our context as well as our users, which is our array list. That's it. Of course, we're also going to move over to our. Alright, so guys, here, this is our project right here. Okay, this is our stuff right here. You can see our grid view server is empty. If we come click our far button, downloading JSON, then of course, you can see it passes our JSON data and presents it right here nicely, of course, in our CAD views. Grid view. Okay, so this is it, guys. Of course, if we click a single item, it opens for us the detailed activity of that particular item. You can see passing in our image by the static, we pass the name, email, and of course, right here, the description. Of course, we're also using some static data. Okay, so guys, this is it. Of course, our data rate is dynamic. You can see our data is getting passed dynamically, as you can see, whatever we click is getting passed over here. This is it guys. This is of course what we've looked at. Okay, I'm hoping you guys have enjoyed this tutorial. We're going to attach the source code below. Please, if you have, hit the like button, share it with friends and family, and also make sure that you subscribe so that you never miss any of our tutorials. We normally do post our tutorials quite regularly. Otherwise, take care. I'll catch you in the next tutorial.